This is Thoughts Become Things. With each episode, we'll help you reach the highest creative potential that God has for you. With your host, a teacher, life coach, a dream coach, and motivational speaker, Jeremy Lopez.
Hello again, everyone, and welcome to another exciting podcast of Thoughts Become Things. I'm Jeremy Lopez, and I'm so excited you guys decided to join with me this week. I tell you, it's been a very busy week for me. I'm doing prophecies for people like crazy. We're doing dream interpretations. I'm doing life coaching sessions. This has been a powerful month where people are starting to sort of come out of that COVID mentality, from being sort of secluded from everything, and they're like ripping it up. They're like wanting to be able to get in here and start, decorating their life and designing their life by creating their thoughts and speaking life into existence, and changing things and restructuring things. I'm really liking this season. And I just want to take a moment just to sort of talk to you guys for a minute. I'm not really going to do a teaching, but I'm going to share with you guys just something that's been on my heart, and that is, it's time to come out. And it really is, because this is a season that God put in my heart where, out of all the COVID, all the things that maybe secluded you, let me tell you something. If many of you guys were really smart during the COVID, you wouldn't sit back and say, oh man, I can't get out, I couldn't do this, I couldn't do that. You would have taken that time in your cocooning state of being, of consciousness as I call it, that cocooning state of COVID, and you would have built a vision like none other. You would have prepared yourself to say, when this COVID's over, here's what I'm going to do. And creating a vision and getting an outline, and you would have been able to sit here and say, you know what, I'm going to make plans, I'm going to start thinking all the things I need to think right now, and start putting my action behind my faith the moment this COVID's over, and I'm going to begin to build my identity, build my self-esteem, sort of be the person God wants me to be. And so I'm hoping and praying that all of you did. If not, you know what, then we've wasted like almost a year of just nothingness, right? But God always lets me know every time that when something comes in your life, and let's say, for example, when you find yourself at a place where you feel like you're being cocooned a little bit, you know what? That's the time when you got to really begin to look at that and say, okay, you know what? Here's what's happening is I've got to begin to realize that I'm in a cocoon state where I need to pay attention to everything in my life. I need to be able to really pay attention to, this season of my life. And what is this season calling me to? What is this season wanting me to do? This season is wanting me to what? Pay attention to this. This season's requiring me to make an outline. This season's requiring me to do this. Remember, every season of our lives and every day of our lives, every moment of our lives, we move into the universal law and principle of reaping and sowing. I was sharing the other day at church when we had this sort of class, and I said, people don't realize that we can, as Christians, we call it sowing and reaping. But the truth is, every single religion on planet Earth has their own type of sowing and reaping. I mean, Buddhism calls it like a type of karma. You have it all through, Hinduism, and you have it through Buddhism, and you have it through, Islam. And you might say, well, I don't care about these other religions, Jeremy. Well, you should, because you have to understand that when something cross-pollinates, and all that means basically is that when it crosses over into something else, when something cross-pollinates into other things that are sort of, we'll say, likened unto you. Because like I said before, you have to face reality. Even though we say Christianity is not a religion, it's a relationship. Well, that's true. However, it's also religion. I mean, that's in that, if you go to a scholar or a professor, at a college, they're going to say these are religions, And so you have to understand that through this type of belief system that we choose to believe is real through Christ, then you have to understand that if that crosses over to even other religions, that tells us something. That tells me that this thing is not only true because I shouldn't believe it because it's in the Bible, but I'm going to believe it even more to think, wow, this is a universal thing. Like, everybody understands the principle, the concept, that whatever I put out there, I'm going to get back. And so you have to understand, that makes it even, it doesn't make it more powerful, but to you it'll be more reaffirming to say, man, this thing is real. You know what I mean? And so you have to begin to realize that this is an important issue. And when you understand that life is about what you put out there and what you're going to get back, and life is about, preparation, and if you think about even Jesus in the sense of like, there was this preparation time, he died on the cross, he resurrects from the dead, and yet there's preparation seasons. There's the third day of resurrection, there's preparation day before. You have to understand that everything involves preparation and cocooning and isolation. These are healthy things for us, folks. Very healthy. And understanding that process, because it's part of your process of life, then you realize whenever you feel like you've been secluded, whenever you feel like you've been maybe you can't go to work for a couple of weeks, or maybe COVID hits and you can't go for months, or you know, something happens within your life where everything sort of feels like it's sort of pushed back, hey, rejoice. When people tell me, oh, must be the devil, must be, you know, I want somebody to say, first of all, I love you, but please get a little bit of maturity, because we don't need to go there. That's sort of very immature. The maturity statement says, you know what? If things are being pushed back from my life, then I'm going to take advantage of this situation. Because how many of you can honestly say, if you work, let's say, 9 to 5 every single day, and you come home, take care of children, your wife, your husband, whatever, and all of a sudden, you know, your job calls you and says, hey, you know, you've got 3 weeks of paid vacation, you haven't taken it yet, and so we're going to have to sort of make you, because you can't pull, you know, carry it over into a new year, so we're going to pretty much make you. You have to take off the next 2 weeks. Now, here's what's happening. You have two options here. One is you could say, oh my gosh, I can't believe this. Like, you know, they're making me take off. What's wrong? Why are they doing this to me? Or if you're smart, you'll say, wait a minute. Hold on. Obviously, there's something in this universe that God wants me to see, that obviously I'm being sort of quote-unquote forced to stay at home. And by the way, folks, it's really sad that you're having to be forced to take your vacation time because you don't allow yourself a time of rest and relaxation. So shame on you, first of all. If your company ever makes you do that, shame on you. You're not being a good steward of your life, all right? And your relaxation, your time of peace. So take advantage of it. You know, Ecclesiastes says there's a time of war, a time of peace. There's a time, you know, to cry. There's a time to mourn. There's a time to rejoice. And so there should be a time. These are elements of your life you have to have. And so the other option is either be mad because they're forcing you to take off, or the other option is, you know what, hey, it's not a bad thing. Like, I'm going to enjoy this. I should enjoy this 2 weeks. And in my enjoyment time, I can prepare for what is to become of me. I can prepare for what is about to happen here. And so this is a good thing. So I would say this to you. If many of you did not do this during COVID, I'm going to be honest with you. Love you, but shame on you. You just lost a non-productive year. If you're like me and you prepared and you got a vision and you're ready to set sail, you know, set the sail in the seven seas, so to say, with your vision and your manifestation, guess what? Way to go. Kudos to you, my friend. You know, high five. Because this is the idea you've got to begin to move into. And I would say this to many of you. If you right now, and by the way, folks, never too late. No condemnation. It's never too late to start your life's journey. That's a great thing about the kingdom of God. Never too late. If you're at that place right now where you say, you know, hey, it's never too late for me, right, Jeremy? I can do this. You know, Jeremy's right. I should have done this. I didn't. But hey, grace, 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 right? Compassion, I want myself, then I would say take today to start. If you feel like something's been pushed back in your life, maybe you might say to yourself, man, I've been trying to get this house for so long, and it's like it's, you know, it's and like it won't go through, and I've been like waiting on this house to come through, and I've been, you know, or waiting on this job, I've been waiting. If you're in the waiting room of your life right now, Don't act like it's some kind of bad thing. You know, I say this a lot on my Instagram lives on Monday morning at 10 a.m. Central Time, and that is this: quit being a drama queen. I mean, let's just face it. Christians are notorious for being a bunch of drama queens. And I hate to say that term, but it's true. Because the idea for many of you is to quit being so dramatic about life. Look at this and say, hey, you know what? If this is something that I'm sort of having to do, and here's the thing. If someone's making you, you know, sit still, if someone's trying to make you take vacation, if your husband or wife or children are saying, hey, mom or dad, you need to take this, then you know what? That's a bad thing, folks. No one should have to tell you that. And you know, because obviously they might be speaking from the voice of God to say, hey, I'm telling you, because you obviously don't know how to your own discipline of your own life and your own body, you need to take this, all right? So do that today. If you're in that place right now where everything feels sort of pushed back, you can't really get that job you want right now, can't really get the house, you've been waiting on this new house to finish that you made, you know, you put the contract on and subdivision hasn't been made yet, or you're just waiting on this to happen, hey, Take it with a grain of salt. In other words, take it with joy, because I guarantee you, it's God's way of saying, "Hey, hello, you're being cocooned right now. enjoy the journey, get refreshed, get a jump start, recalibrate, you know, per se, and then while you're doing that, create a new outline of what's going to happen when you do get this job, you do get this house, you do get the wife, you do get the husband, you do get the kids. Because if you don't, without a vision, you will perish, and you won't know what to do at all. You will literally not have nothing to do, and you'll be saying, man, I've been waiting on this, but now I don't know what to do. Now I'm overwhelmed. Well, you're overwhelmed because you did not prepare. There's something to be said about people who prepare. Jesus prepared. The disciples prepared. Everybody prepares in their life. And if you're willing to talk about law of attraction, if you're willing to talk about, you know, thoughts become things, if you're willing to talk about the fact that what I am is what I will produce, if you're willing to talk about the fact that you believe thoroughly that you can sort of have a say-so within your destiny of your life, if you believe that, then you owe it to yourself. You owe it to yourself to be still, push back everything, and say, I'm going to enjoy this cocoon state right now. And even though I can't do anything about it as far as making something happen, which I don't need to, if it's not happening, you know, it's like the old saying, if it's not broken, don't fix it. If nothing is making it happen right now, then you know what? I need to enjoy the journey. And here's my time to prepare. Here's my wonderful, beautiful opportunity to plan and prepare and get it ready. I'm excited. And then the moment you're able to take off in that thing, whatever you're waiting to take off in, you already got the plans. You got the vision. And guess what? Think about this. Do you think God will honor you because you have prepared, you've planned, you've got your vision board going on, you got all these pictures on your vision board, you got the outline, man, you got a prophecy, somebody prophesied to you about it, and you wrote it out, and you decided, you know, I'm going to strategize, I'm going to get action, how can I get action behind this, what I need to do, what can I do to make this happen? When you do all of that, do you not think God's going to honor you? Absolutely He will. Because I'm going to be honest with you, if you manifest void in your mind because you don't like the season of void that you're in, I have news for you. The moment life starts back up for you, you will still manifest void. And you know why? Because what you were saying were this, that in the midst of your void of your life, you did not know how to respond to you being by yourself, you being alone. And because you didn't, you gave your life and yourself and your identity void at that moment. And because you did, you're going to get that same reflection in the mirror of your tomorrow, the mirror of your future, nothing but void as well. Are you with me? So don't think for a moment that when your job is being pushed back and you're having to stay home with COVID and you're waiting on this house you're trying to get and you're just waiting and when everything's been pushed back, you know, and don't think for a moment that God's not looking to say, now this is the greatest moment of your life. Let me see what you're going to do with this. You might not think it's the greatest moment, but this is the moment where you are going to try yourself. You're going to tempt yourself. You're going to push yourself, or you're not. And you're going to sit back and just wait on me to do something, or you're waiting on something to happen. Let me tell you something, folks. If you're waiting on life to happen to you, it's not going to happen for you. I watched a TikTok the other day, which I love TikTok. It's just fun and it's like entertaining. But I watched a TikTok the other day, and this lady said something to this nature. She said it like this. She said, if you're waiting on somebody to make you go to the gym, they're never going to come. If you're waiting on somebody to cause you to lose weight or eat better, they're never going to come. If you're waiting on somebody to tell you to, you know, go back to school, they're never going to come. If you're waiting on somebody maybe to bring you a check in the mail, they're never going to come. And the point she was making was so true. Folks, let me tell you something. No one's coming to help you. The truth is, no one's coming to help you. It's not being negative, because God has given you all things that pertain to life and godliness. You have it in your hands to begin to reproduce. You have the seed of faith in you, like the mustard seed, to say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart. And that means God is saying, look, no one's coming to you. Because they don't need to. You don't need anyone else. You've got it inside of yourself. And when you begin to activate the seed inside of you, and you begin to create your life and create your vision and create your destiny and speak life into everything that exists in your world, because you're learning to honor your world and honor you, because you're the one in the world, when you begin to do that, then people will begin to be attracted to you and want to get on board with what you're doing. It's a known fact. People love to follow leaders who are actionary people. People do not follow people that nothing is happening. It's just, I mean, everybody knows that. People don't follow people. You know, no one's going to come to, let's say, for example, to my ministry, if I say, guys, I have no money. I'm desperate. I have no money coming in. I have one supporter. No one else knows about me. I don't have any product, any books. There's not one of you who would say, oh, wow, man, that's interesting. Let me be a part of his life. Most of you would be like, exit out. I don't want to be a part of that. People want to be a part of people's lives who are producers, who are manifestors, that have something going in their life. Because you know why? Because they're proven. Those people are proven that this stuff works. Action behind your faith. And I can tell you right now, in this ministry, we have thousands of supporters. We have hundreds of financial partners. We have people all over the globe that support us. I have three editors that work for me full time that helps me with my books, that I have a book out every month. I have 14 courses out. We have people all over the world who literally every week are trying their best to get a life coaching session from me Tuesdays and Thursdays. And guess what? They're booked every single week. And so when I tell you, we are not just prospering, we're overflowing with people who are saying, your stuff works, Jeremy. It's been proven. You know, it works for me. God is in your ministry. Then you know what? That's what draws people to our ministry. And it's not to pump me up. I don't care about that. You know, I'm just like anybody else, folks. The only difference between me and somebody else is I force my life to work for me. I made my life work for me. I took a dare to believe what God said could happen in my life, and I made it happen. That's what you do, folks. And so I want to encourage all of you guys, take that time. If things are pushed back, take that time to enjoy it and say, this must be a time of upgrade for me. In order for me to have the upgrade of God, I need to create a vision. I need to create something. And let me tell you something. It doesn't matter if you have five vision boards all through your house. If you have five outlines on pages all through every room, I'm going to tell you something. I would tell you like I would tell myself, a lot is never enough. You will never have too many things that are all through your house or on your desk or your computer. It's never enough to have tons of things that are visions in your life of what you are looking for, what you desire, what you want, what you know are hoping for, what you're praying for, what your prophetic words say. It's never going to be enough, folks. That's a beautiful thing about life. It will never be too much. Get as much as you can, folks, because it is your life. When you learn to honor your life, you'll begin to say it's never enough. I can't dream enough. I can't have enough visions every day enough. You know why? Because my life is so worth it. And I got so many things in my life I'm going to accomplish and do. And I'm going to make it happen. And so it's never going to be too much for you, ever. Make sure you are downloading more than enough in your spirit and in your life of everything you have visions for. Because guess what? Honor yourself with tons of visions. Honor yourself with tons of writings upon writings of what you're going to accomplish, what you're going to achieve, what kind of job you're going to have, how you're going to accomplish that job, what kind of schooling you need to go through, who to hook up with, who to get near, who to learn from, who to spend time with, whatever. Make sure you've got tons of people and tons of things surrounding you that are producing. And do not, whatever you do, do not hang around people who are non-productive. Do not get into a place in your life where you're around people who are just, oh, I wish I had this. I'll never have this. Well, one day, someday, you know what? Bless them, love them, and walk away. Hey, I wish the best for you, man, but I gotta go. You know why? Because they're not doing you in your life any good. They're never doing anyone any good. And always remember this. If you're being attracted to somebody who is talking that way, that means you're mirroring that same thing. It might be something God is showing you that's a part of you, that God is saying, hey, I'm showing you this other guy who is actually mimicking you because you attracted him into your life. So you might be the one actually that attracted them because maybe you're the one, hello, that's being a little negative. Maybe you're the one who's always woe is me. And that's a great mirroring effect. If they're in your life, maybe it's a part of who you are. Maybe you can change that and shift it by repentance in the sense of shifting your life into another way of thinking. And then you guess what? You break that contract of attraction. Think about that. You break the contract of your attraction. And then you start vibrating and getting to the will of God where something else is being drawn into your world, which is victory, hope, peace. And then once you've accomplished all that, then you can turn around and bless those who are less fortunate. And you can bless those who need something you have. Think about that, folks. It's time to arise. and create a vision. Thank you so much. You guys are so amazing. I love my audience. I love my partners, my subscribers. You guys are what made me who I am today. And I would never, ever, ever have been anything in my life at all if it hadn't been for every single one of you. So I bless every one of you. Love every one of you. Take these messages to heart. And I want to encourage you, if you're that kind of person listening to this podcast right now saying, Jeremy, what do I do? That's what I want to be. I want to do what you do. I want to live that life that you're accomplishing to live. Here's what I'm going to tell you to do. Go to my website, identitynetwork.net. I will never tell you anything that would just give you a bunch of hype. I'm into giving you action points. Go to the website, identitynetwork.net. Look under my schools and find the School of Law of Attraction. School of the Law of Attraction. If you can't find it, put it in the search engine. Look under the button that says courses. It'll give you a drop-down menu. Scroll down. They're alphabetically ordered. Scroll down to find School of the Law of Attraction. Click on it. You can download the entire school within minutes. I'm one of the few people who actually give you the school. Like, you can actually, you know, purchase a school and download the entire school to where you've got it on your computer always. All these teachings and ebook and stuff that's going to be yours in that course. Plus, there's an extra bonus in that course as well about another part of the law that you can actually dive into to create your life. Or you can order all of them hard copies. And my team can ship it out to you first thing tomorrow morning. And you'll get the box in the mail of all the CDs and the book and everything with it. But download today or order School of the Law of Attraction. This will do you good. It's 100% biblical. So no worries for those of you who are sort of like leery about stuff. I get it. I'm with you. It's 100% biblical. So trust me on this one. You'll love it. But get that today. It'll jumpstart your life. It'll jumpstart the true mind of Christ in you. Now jumpstart everything you need to do in your life that you need, and you owe it yourself. So get that today. And as always, as I close the podcast out, I want to say this to you. Go and create the life you're meant to create. Go and create the day-to-day that you know God desires for you to have. God bless.
This has been the Thoughts Become Things podcast with Jeremy Lopez, helping you reach your highest creative potential that God has for you. For more episodes, products, and information on Jeremy, visit www.identitynetwork.net.